Welcome to rygurukul.com. In this video, we'll discuss about software testing trends in 2022. When we talk about software testing, it's a very important thing required for certifying any products which is going into life. Any product is in development, which is again needed to be tested and verified so that we can remove defects from the products or make the products active and bug-free. So we'll discuss here which all software testing trends are required in 2022. Top software testing trends in 2022 and 21: continued rise of AI in testing. Testing of microservices will continue to introduce new testing patterns and mindset. More focus on software quality from product. More focus on software quality from code rather than manual documents. CI/CD without automated test code will be considered useless, and more new testing tools will evolve with new features. So we'll discuss these points in further part of video. And if you're visiting this channel first time and want to learn about software testing, don't forget to watch my complete software testing playlist. I will include the URL in my description tab. And if you have not yet subscribed to the channel, consider subscribing and pressing the bell icon for further updates. Now, when we talk about top testing trends in 2021, which is the test automation, normally when we are testing any product which is required to be automated, because everything which we are doing manually, which kills our time as well as effort of the resources, automating as a well-known solutions where we can build a product or test or certify the products as soon as possible. Automation also helps us to save some time and effort of our resources, which we can utilize it in any other work. Then automation also gives us privilege to get our work done quickly as soon as possible. And codeless rise of API in testing again helped us to achieve the crucial or complex testing in SAP, ERP, or HRMS related applications. And then QA apps is also helping us to achieve our testing target as soon as possible. IoT testing, that is Internet of Things testing, also required. Then robotics process automation helped us to build a scriptless automation flow for any of our products. This has also helped us to get some detail without doing any coding stuff. So we'll see here in detail. Now, when we talk about top software testing trends in 2022, first is continued rise of AI in testing. Testing of microservices will introduce new testing platform and mindset. More focus on software quality code rather than manual documents. And CI/CD again helped us to use useless automation to minimize useless automation flow. More new testing tools also introduced inside the market. Now, when we talk about continued rise in testing, so this is a phenomena which we are using for testing of API applications. When we have any API which is triggered by any AI and image recognition process and vision API, that will help us to achieve our goal. AI with natural language based tools also help us to achieve our motto within our target timelines. AI in UI element identifier and resolve automated test issues. This also helps us to achieve our goal in such a way, like when we want to test any PDF documents. So AI is helping us to test this PDF document automatically. If you want to test any logo or if you want to test any of the images, that is also covered by using AI. If we have any human interventions required, like chatbot or any other things, which we can achieve it by using AI, which is artificial intelligence. So AI helped us to achieve our task in complex activity as well, which is not possible with any other way of testing. Now, testing of microservices will continue to introduce new testing patterns and mindsets, more and more focused on the domain services like integration testing instead of UI testing, contrast testing, or by services or isolation instead of API testing. So let's consider one example here. Let's talk about e-commerce applications like Walmart. So if we are testing on Walmart, we have many dynamic contents are available. Without using AI and without doing integration testing, it is not possible to see the testing will be completed. Even service isolation instead of API testing. API testing is also required for these type of applications. Without that, we cannot proceed on certification stage. So API, it plays a very crucial role in these type of applications. On testing, these applications will cover everything in that module. So if we talk about these are the services, so UI is the first test which we are doing. So in terms of UI, we are testing the images, product cycles, then contents, their logos, then video, the product previews, and there are a lot many things which is available on Walmart website. If we are checking any products and where this lying, which all vendors are there or sellers are there, so for testing this, UI tests will be required. Then end-to-end test is again plays a major role when we are testing these type of big applications which contains a lot of dynamic features. And for testing this, definitely UI and end-to-end testing required. Integration testing. Every modules cannot be built in one shot. So each and every small pieces will build one by one and post that this will be integrated into any big applications. So integration testing again plays a very important role. So let's say if we talk about the product purchase. So product purchase is built, might be built in separate instance or built by different set of developer. And then we have payment gateway. So after building both these things, we are integrating together. So integration testing is again required for any products to give certifications. And this integration testing helps us to understand their internal structure, their database, the services, web services, these all were required. Even mobile notifications in this type of application plays a very important role. So we have to test with the multiple platform and multiple devices. That's the only reason integration testing plays a very important role. And unit testing will be done either by the developer or their separate instance of the developer so that we can target it maximum out of it. Now, when we talk about these type of testing, more focus on software quality from code rather than manual documents, because nowadays few of the organizations are targeting to have these type of documents available. But when we are moving these type of products for the end user, we always have to see what to do, where to, and who to perform this activity. So companies are adopting agile principles and getting rid of documents as much as possible, at least for the how-to of software development and testing. Most of the documentations in companies are either what to, where to, and who to. But here, in testing trends, we always have to ask how to perform this activity and which all the set of team members who is doing this activity, which all skill sets they have, what is the path they are following to perform this type of activity, which is very important and required for complete testing. So these are the contents we have to test it in prior and even in every stages so that our release should be planned on time. Otherwise, if we'll find some defect at the latter stages, the cost of fixing that defect is multiple or 10 times as compared to first instance which we have received. So this is how we are planning to build any products bug free. Now again, CI/CD, there is continuous implementation and continuous development without automated test code will be considered useless. So if we have automated test sets, let's see, consider one example here. Developer has built a code and they have posted this code on server. Now, if you don't have CI/CD pipeline, it will not start automatically deploying. But if we are triggering manually, so that is useless. That's the reason the code is required to be auto-triggered. Rather than doing manual efforts, we can auto-trigger for the deployment activity. And once this is deployed, if we have automated set of test code available on our CI/CD pipeline framework, that will trigger automatically to start executing the test cases. So it will not wait for any human being who will trigger this process. So automated tests will be considered as the most of intrinsic part of even application build and deploy from CI/CD pipeline, as quality is considered as the foremost part of application development. Every code commit from a developers will trigger complete test execution, making quality first product development. And these are the DevOps teams who is performing this configurations in the CI/CD, but the code will be built by either developer or automation team. So here, if we talk about the plan, code, build, and test, which is a general approach. And now, once the test will be done, they will release into different form. Deploy, operate, and then monitor these type of applications help us to get successful customer feedback. So CI/CD again play a very important role if we have automated test code. Now, when we talk about process of CI/CD, the traditional way, how the traditional way we are following in any enterprises or any projects. Let's consider we have three programmers, programmer A, B, and C. Programmer one will ask for the change. Here we have change. Once the changes have been done, the code will go for the merging perspective. Programmer B will again build a code and programmer B will send for the merging. Programmer C again perform the same activity and they will send it to the code base to merge this code. And once this code will be merged, QA team will start doing testing, which is again create a mess here. The reason behind that, let's consider programmer A is building functionality 1, programmer B is building functionality 2, programmer C is building functionality 3. So what happens if QA team will start doing the testing, they might get confused because of the three program built together. And then they might end up with releasing of some defects or bug within that product, which will be deployed into productions, which is again disaster for any product and or any organizations. So if we want to remove this phase, then if we have CI/CD automated set, then what will it will do? Once the code will be deployed or code will be stored on a server, it will match with the current build. If the code will find it out, the build available on server is higher than our available build on production activity, it will start deploying automatically. And once the deployment is done, it will start testing this. So within few hours or within a time duration, this will test complete code and release the final product. So more new testing tools will evolve with new features. It means initially when we are talking about 1980s, 1990s, that time waterfall methodology was there and manual testing will be done that time. But within that 1990 to 2000, bulky automations tool introduced with experimentations with different development approaches. And within that 2000 to 2010, more robust automation tool open source framework introduced, which considered agile approaches, faster release cycles. And after 2010, the game changed very rapidly. So DevOps continuous testing and CI/CD is more about to scale. And autonomous testing, machine learning, and AI is the big features, which is a part of future. Nowadays, we are using RPA-based tool, which is having AI-relevant testing approaches. So in past few years, we have seen that trend in new tools is upcoming or is having the advanced skill set to test our applications within that duration and within that timeline so that we can get the product or that product is bug-free. So this is the major trends or changes happen throughout the years. So that's all from this video about software testing trends in 2022. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you think so, this will be useful. Don't forget to share within your circle. Thank you for watching.